Hello everyone. Today we're showcasing a Nevada slurry tanker. This is an autofill model, a 10,000 litre single axle. What you'll notice is how manoeuvrable it is, as it came in through that gateway pretty tight. And in this case, he turns around and then backs up to his autofill. So you'll see the docking station there with a rubber cone. He's lowering the arm to make it easy for him to be aligned. And the good thing about that rubber cone is that alignment doesn't have to be exactly perfect. He's in there and he'll be turning this PTO on and starting the vacuum in that tank. So it takes a few minutes to fill up. As it's filling up, you'll see the level coming up on the gauge there. So that's a big sight glass. And the good thing about that sight glass is not only when you're loading, but also when you're spreading, you can see the level dropping. So he's full now, he's lifting his arm up, and when that arm comes up, it shuts off the gate valve and it also switches the vacuum pump into pumping mode. So now he's driving off to his paddock. When he gets to the paddock, he'll turn the PTO back on and that will start pressurizing the tank to spray the effluent out. So you'll see as he comes into his paddock shortly, it's a very tight gateway. And again, with that single axle, nice and easy manoeuvrability. One downside to a single axle is that they are a little bit more bouncy. The tandems do follow very, very nicely and smooth. So you'll see that as he drives across the paddock, there's a little bit of a bounce there, but hey, not too bad. So this is a 10,000 litre model. And we generally recommend 100 litres per horsepower. So this is a 10,000 litre, so 100 horsepower tractor is what you sort of need to pull it. So he's turned his PTO on there and he's away spreading, open the valve and start spreading. So watch that rain wave in action. It's quite a unique device, the Nevada rain wave. So it's self-drive mechanism, so it spreads without any electric or hydraulic mechanisms. And check it how even it is with its application. Really accurate, and both in its placement and also the spread across the whole width of the bout width. So he's spreading along there, there's virtually no wind drift you'll see, and a nice big droplets that fall right down through the grass into the soil. So there's virtually no tainting of the crop either. So as he's driving along, he's just spreading. If you've got GPS, it's really good to be able to track it, but even without it, you can see where you're going okay. And then once he gets to the end of his load, you'll see the level dropping on his gauge, of course. But then when he gets to the end of the load, you'll see how the rain wave stops spreading side to side. So at that point, he can turn off the PTO, which stops air going into the tank. And then he will close the back valve and head back for another load. So typically you can do about 4 loads an hour, or 3, depending on how far you're traveling. So thanks for watching. See you next time.